If your little one is just learning to talk, then chances are you're noticing each and every new word that they're trying out, and you're thinking about what words they might learn next. When children come to me for some early speech and language therapy, often the thing that we're thinking about is what keywords are they using already, and what are some really useful ones that we can help them learn to really build their ability to communicate, to request things that they want, to talk about things that are really interesting to them. And so in this video, I'm going to give you 5 keywords that we often choose within speech and language therapy sessions to help a toddler on their way towards becoming a confident communicator. And by the end of this, you're going to have a little list of some words and the Makaton to go with it that you can use with your toddler, plus some extra things to bear in mind along the way. So let's get going. The first thing to just mention is the reason that it's useful to have a clear set of simple words in your head that you're helping your child learn is because then you start sharing that with everyone else. All the key adults around a child are tuned in and thinking, oh, here's an opportunity to use this word. Oh, and actually, I know the sign to go with it. So with that in mind, the first word that I wanted to share with you is more. And the Makaton for that is like you have a little cup in your hand and you're filling it up. More. So say you have a bag of hula hoops, love hula hoops, and you're giving your toddler a bowl with 2 or 3 hula hoops in it. Rather than giving them the whole bag, then you have the opportunity to model to them, oh, more. Okay, second word actually uses 2 fingers, again. Again. Again is a useful one when you're playing together. For example, if you're at the park and you're spinning around on the roundabout, and when it comes to a stop and your child's saying, hey, like they want another turn, then you can say, oh, again. Here we go, again, we can spin. You can see we're thinking about how we can model that keyword lots of times. Next week, we're gonna think a little bit more about some specific strategies to encourage and help your child to use these words. But today, let's think about that key handful of words that are gonna be useful to your toddler so that you and the adults around you are modeling them first. Okay, so we are on to number 3, stop. Now, this is a safety word. It's important if your child understands stop, but it can also be a really fun and powerful word for them to use themselves because we can start playing go and stop games. I made a video about how you might like to play stop and go games with musical instruments, and I'll link that around here. You can also play stop and go if you're running or jumping or playing with some pouring, filling and emptying things, and for them to have a go at realizing that when they use words, they're really powerful. When I say stop, the adults change their behavior, and we can play around and experiment with this in a fun way. Next suggestion, mainly because I really love the sign for it, is wow. So we've got 3 fingers like W's, wow. Now, the reason that I suggest wow as a keyword is because it's a good early sound. Your child can see what you're doing with your lips when you're doing it, wow. And also because it's not about making a request or asking for something, which is often where our first core words come from, but it's just social commentary. Being able to share the things that you're excited about and using the word wow is a really fun one to play around with this. Another what word for our 5th one is where. Now, where is really useful for asking for help, getting the thing that you need, and it's a really good bridge towards starting to put 2 words together. I made a video all about how you can use where to start bridging to 2 word sentences, so I'll link that below as well. Now, I said that we would just look at 5, but I wanted to add in one really key thing. Think about what their favorite things are. What are the things that your toddler wants to talk about and their favorite actions or places? If you want to just pick a selection of words, don't just go for the words that a speech and language therapist would recommend to you, go for the ones that feel like ones that would be really motivating for your child as well. Now, next week, I'm gonna be sharing with you some top tips for how you can teach new words to your toddler, some little things that can help you along the way to encouraging them to use new words. And if you would like more suggestions, activities, and ideas for helping your little one along the way to becoming a confident communicator, then do sign up for the monthly Dash of Salt newsletter, where I send you monthly ideas, tips, tricks, and general encouragement straight to your inbox. I'll link that below. And meanwhile, keep going. Remember, every tiny step that you and your little one take together is a step in the right direction. You are doing so well, and it's really lovely to see you here today. So thank you for joining me, and I'll see you next time.